I'm Jared, and I'm going to answer your questions. Thanks. Let's get started. I think my favorite 80s movie is probably UHF, featuring none other than Weird Al Yankovic. I just remember being a kid, and it was really kind of one of those wacky movies, and just really kind of bizarre, and I don't know, I always really laughed a lot at it. And then it's kind of weird to grow up a little bit and go back and watch the movie and see that there were a lot of things that I kind of missed from being so young and a lot of things going over my head. So definitely way up there for me. Forever Halloween was a totally different experience for all of us. We had to relearn how to work together in a studio. So I think that going into the process, we didn't really know what to expect. But coming out of it, I think that we learned a lot about how to get rid of a lot of the unnecessary things that you tend to do when you're in a studio. And you can cut and paste everything and chop things up. We had to do everything real, and I think the album ended up feeling pretty real. So it just changed the way that I look at music and the way that people have made albums for the past, you know, half a century, and made me feel more confident when we play those songs live on stage. It's easier to do, so. I don't know if you mean good or bad habits. I guess I could start with bad. I bite my nails, like really bad. I get nervous. Sometimes I'm watching movies or I don't know. Things that make me nervous make me bite my nails. I've never been able to stop. I guess it's not a bad thing when it comes to playing guitar, but it still sucks. Good habits. Pretty clean. I like to clean up. I'm normally the guy that cleans the bus. Sometimes I stay behind when everyone goes places just because I like to clean. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Some would disagree, but I don't. So there. That's a tough one. I think that given this lifestyle, it's hard to even know what's happening a couple months from now. So, you know, we find out about things way in advance sometimes, and sometimes last minute. So you really can never predict anything in this business. In 10 years, I would like to see us still performing, still recording, still touring. It's really the only thing I know how to do. So, hopefully, I'm still doing this in 10 years, but maybe it's a little bit more of this. We've been doing it for about 7 years now, so I feel like I'm at a point where I can say I've learned something. Mainly it's that you can't trust anybody besides yourself. If you want something done, you're going to have to probably do it yourself, especially if you want it done right. I've learned that it's okay to say no to things. That was something that I feel like we were afraid to do in the beginning, just because who knew what would come of anything, and, you know, it's just kind of like, we used to just think saying yes to everything was the best option, and I think over time you learn that you always have this right to say no. So if you don't want to do something, say no. See, here's the thing. Now we're talking about breakfast food, so I have to try to not get really excited, because that's my favorite thing in the world, breakfast. Omelette, duh. This is so easy, it's so simple. Think about it. Scrambled eggs. You just have eggs. Omelette, so much stuff in there. You could put really anything in there. The options are endless. Omelette. I think the first thing I'm going to do is probably sleep, because that flight's pretty brutal. It's not too bad, but it's not the best. And then when I wake up, I'm probably going to go Nando's, or maybe Wagamama, depends on which one I'm closer to. And then, I don't know. I really don't know. It remains to be seen, I guess. Maybe I'll go record shopping. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll find some clothes. Maybe I won't. I'm definitely going to soundcheck at some point. I know that's going to happen. I'm definitely going to play a show. But the first thing I'm going to do is sleep. Thanks again for asking me all your questions. I had fun answering them, and hopefully we can do this again soon sometime. We'll see you guys either in Australia or the United States or the UK, Philippines, or, man, pretty much anywhere else. So, yeah, see you soon. Take care.